Hi, I am Hudson Meeks, and I am a developer in the customer engineering team at BMC Software.
This video is the second video of two covering how to tune the patrol agent for remote data collection. The configuration discussed in this video applies to patrol agents that are dedicated to collecting large amounts of data from multiple nodes that are managed remotely. If you have not already viewed the first video covering patrol agent tuning for remote collection, please do before viewing this video. In the first video, we used the patrol console to disable the recovery action for the patrol agent work rate. You will need Patrol Configuration Manager to manage the agent setting discussed in this video. The primary use cases are the same ones discussed in the first video, and they include monitoring with the Remote Windows Knowledge Module, the Remote Unix Knowledge Module, and the vCenter Knowledge Module. The purpose discussed in the first video applies here as well. Out of the box, the patrol agent is configured to automatically scale back data collection when its work rate exceeds a certain threshold. This is to ensure the agent does not consume excessive resources when other processes such as application code and database applications on the managed node need those resources. These out-of-the-box settings are proper configuration for most implementations where the agent is installed locally on the managed node. However, this does not make sense for nodes that are dedicated to patrol agents used for remote data collection. If an agent doing remote data collection is left with the default settings, the agent will most likely slip its data collection schedule and data points will be missed. The first video covered how to disable the recovery action that is triggered when the patrol agent work rate goes into alarm. This recovery action resets the agent's run queue schedule, and we do not want that to happen for agents that are dedicated to remote monitoring. You should apply the configuration shown in the first video before applying the settings shown in this video. This video shows how to set the agent's run queue schedule properly for an agent that is dedicated to remote monitoring. Okay, let's take a look at the product. Here in Patrol Configuration Manager, we have a target agent that is intended to be used for remote monitoring. In order to change the agent setting value for the run queue schedule, we'll need to right-click on this managed node, go to Configuration, and choose Get with Defaults. Unless you've already changed this, the value will only be stored in the default settings and not in a general get. So if we click Get with Defaults, it'll run out there and grab my default settings as well as all of the other configuration changes that have been made to this agent. We'll click OK, and then we can drill down in the PCM folder here under Backup and find our managed node, expand it, choose the last data set that we just got, data set regarding the configuration that is, and right click up here at the top, choose search, and enter the string just simply run queue. We'll find what we're looking for here. If we click OK there, we now see a number of different settings. The setting that we care about for run queue schedule policy is the one here at the bottom. And what we want to do at this point is save this as a rule set. So we'll save that selection. I'll just call it run queue. And tag the word remote on the end of this. Go ahead and save that. Click OK. Minimize our list, and now we see the run queue rule set that I created here. Remote meaning the setting we want for remote agents. Agents that are doing remote monitoring, that is. If we double click on this guy, we can edit it, and the value we want to enter here is the value of 2. Now you can read more about this particular value and other values available for this particular agent setting in the Agent Configuration and Administration Manual. We'll go ahead and save this, which it's actually already saved. We can also save it to the file up there to make sure that it's actually saved to disk. And now we can drag and drop this and apply it to the agent. And this should be applied after having disabled the recovery action on work rate executions per minute, because if we don't do this after disabling that recovery action, then this setting can be inadvertently changed by the recovery action. We'll go ahead and click OK there, and now that rule has been applied to the agent. That concludes this video. Thank you for watching the video, and thank you for using BMC products.